soldier instantly understood Roy Moore's character after they were invited to Brothel. Which version of Roy Moore is a real, the devoted husband and public servant, or the deviant who allegedly had a penchant for young girls? That's the question that voters in Alabama are being forced to ask, after serious but unproven accusations of misconduct began plaguing the special Senate race for Jeff Sessions' vacant seat. The mainstream media and the left have appeared downright desperate to paint the candidate as a villain, but now a man who knew Roy Moore in Vietnam is speaking up about his character and morals. Former Army officer Bill Stahel served with Moore during the Vietnam War in the 1970s, the same era when the allegations against the candidate supposedly took place. In an open letter published by Yellowhammer News, the man who served in the 504th Military Police Battalion and later as an assistant United States attorney revealed a side of Moore that says a lot about his character. "I knew him well in my first 4 months in country before I was reassigned within the battalion to another location. During that time, I grew to admire him," Stahel wrote about Moore. While in Vietnam, "there came a time when another officer invited Roy and me to go with him into town after duty hours for a couple of beers," the veteran recalled. "On other occasions with other officers, we would go to the officers' club at the Air Force Base, but on this occasion, he told us he knew of another place in town," explained Bill Stahel. It turned out that the third officer had a low morality excursion planned, but Roy Moore wanted nothing to do with it. "When we arrived at the place and went inside, it was clear to Roy and me that he had taken us to a brothel. That officer appeared to know people there, as he was greeted by one or two young women in provocative attire," Stahel continued. "In less time than it took any of the women to approach us, Roy turned to me and said words to this effect, 'We shouldn't be here. I'm leaving.'" Make no mistake, these were young girls, perhaps underage, in a place where Moore and the other soldiers could have easily acted with impunity. If Moore wanted to act the way his enemies claim, this certainly would have been the place to do it, thousands of miles from home, with almost no chance of repercussions. Instead, Moore refused. "That evening, if I didn't know it before, I knew then that with Roy Moore I was in the company of a man of great self-control, discipline, honor, and integrity," said Stahel. "While there were other actions by Roy that reinforced my belief in him, that was the most telling. I reject what are obvious, politically motivated allegations against Roy of inappropriate dating behavior. What I saw, felt and knew about him in Vietnam stands in stark contrast to those allegations," the Vietnam veteran stated. "What is more likely, that after showing himself to have self-control and honor during the chaos of Vietnam, Roy Moore suddenly became a wild deviant the next year. Which conveniently was never brought up by anybody during the following decades in the public light. Or, as a second possibility, Moore's unexpected primary win suddenly made him a political enemy, and establishment politicians decided to smear him with flimsy allegations which don't seem to match any of the other evidence. Voters will decide that for themselves on December 12th. But the soldier who fought side by side with Roy Moore has seen enough. He's witnessed what the former judge is actually like when the public isn't watching.